Tonight, a political hit on the Archbishop of San Salvador. In Cairo, the former Shah rests, causing unrest in the continuing hostage drama.
Two big presidential primaries upcoming on the East Coast tomorrow, expected to even further narrow the field in both political parties.
And weeks of tournament play come to an end as college basketball crowns its champion for 1980 tonight.
We'll have those stories next when Eyewitness News joins you.
If it's been a while since you've eaten crab legs, let Red Lobster remind you how. Uh-huh, right in the middle. That's right, it pays to dig deep. Oh, dip that sweet, delicate meat into rich melted butter. Ah, there you go. Now, if you'd like more practice, we know where you can get plenty. Red Lobster's serving them tonight. Lots of them.
Red Lobster for the seafood lover in you.
Tom McNamee's country shoes that go a country mile, with a lot of country comfort and a lot of country style. Get out in the open, get out to the land. Your heart is in the country, put your feet in Tom McCann.
Tom McCann country shoes in leather or suede.
If your heart is in the country, put your feet in Tom McCann.
What happens when you bring home a poppin' fresh pie? No wonder people love poppin' fresh pies. We make them fresh daily with just one thing in mind, the very best flavor. We use sweet, natural ingredients like fresh butter and fresh whipping cream. You just can't buy a fresher tasting pie.
'Cause you can't get fresher than poppin' fresh.
Stay tuned for Eyewitness News next on Channel 7. This is Eyewitness News with Fahey Flynn, Joel Daly, Dr. Walt Lyons, and Tim Weigel.
How do you do, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Fahey Flynn, and here's what's happening. Four gunmen walked up to the Archbishop of San Salvador as he was leading a funeral mass tonight and shot him to death at point-blank range. 63-year-old Archbishop Oscar Romero thus becomes the latest victim of terror in that strife-torn Central American nation of El Salvador. He was an outspoken supporter of human rights. He was nominated for a Nobel Prize in 1979. His violent death came following a weekend of slaughter. 25 people were shot to death Sunday in an apparent ambush of an army patrol. And following that bloodshed, Archbishop Romero called on the civilian military junta to stop its repression. Tonight, he was gunned down. Tehran Radio is calling on its countrymen to gather at the U.S. Embassy tomorrow for a mass protest in protest of the deposed Shah's move from Panama to Egypt. Security around the embassy is already tightened. In bitter reaction to the Shah's move, an Islamic judge in Iran has said that some of the hostages will be tried as spies and those convicted will be jailed. The word from the White House is unchanged in response. The United States would oppose such a trial and would hold Iran, quote, fully responsible for such a grave action. Joel?
Hey, the former Shah rushed to Egypt ostensibly for emergency cancer surgery. But shortly after his arrival, doctors who examined him suggested postponing any action until the Shah's improvement improves somewhat. This is obviously not the Shah of Iran arriving in Egypt, but he arrived at the hospital in Egypt with a temperature of 104 degrees. Egyptian President Sadat, who scheduled a bedside visit tomorrow with the former monarch, told reporters that the move is permanent, that the former Shah of Iran will make Egypt his home. Here in Chicago, a jury today recommended that 19-year-old Juan Caballero die in the electric chair for his role in the slashing murders of three suburban teenagers last year. Caballero and a friend, Luis Ruiz, both members of the Latin King street gang, were convicted of murder, armed violence, and unlawful restraint. During a drug deal, their three victims were held in a parked car and stabbed one at a time by Caballero while Ruiz stood guard. Fahey?
Joel, tonight Chicago police need our help in finding the driver of a car that struck and killed a 9-year-old Southwest Side girl and did not stop. The hit and run happened on Sunday afternoon as little Nanette Gonzalez played in front of her home. She dashed into the street, for what reason no one knows, but she did, and she was killed.
Witnesses gave us a color of white, and we found evidence at the scene, debris from the vehicle that we link to that particular model type car, 77 or 78 Chevrolet Caprice. So anybody with information, we'd certainly wish they'd call our office at 744-4824.
Let me repeat that number for you. It's 744-4824, and the number is available 24 hours a day.
If you're a so-called average American breadwinner, you'll be paying Uncle Sam and other officials until May 11th. That's what the Tax Foundation Incorporated